National Press Day is a symbolic of a free and responsible press in India. This was the day on which the Press Council of India started functioning as a moral watchdog to ensure that the press maintained the high standards. The main objective for the launch of lecture series, ma'am, is to propagate the values that Mr. Bhatia stood for, the improvement in the standards of journalism in our country. We want to bring the best mind and eminent personalities to our campus for critical dialogue and creative participatory. Highly respected Dr. Kiran Bedi's grit, determination, discipline is a source of inspiration for all of us. With those words, I have the honor of inviting Honorable Lieutenant Governor to deliver the address, Dr. Kiran Bedi.
Prestigious lecture, remembering Mr. Prem Bhatia. I also grew up reading his articles, whether in the Tribune, the Hindu, and elsewhere. Totally a legend of his times, lived a good long life, healthy life, and a very versatile, from being a cricketer to an ambassador to a journalist and other, and also in the radio and also joining the government. Very, very versatile. So we remember him all with great respect and fond memories. I also want to thank the college for inviting me today. I have also memories of your college, where when I was posted in Chandigarh, where I got an opportunity to connect with your college and your students. I want to thank Dr. Priya Chadda for inviting me for this event also, who's also the moderating and introducing me. Also want to thank your Dr. Joshi, your General Secretary of the GGSDS College Society, and all others who are behind the event. I believe you have a few questions in mind. Who's going to moderate? You got questions. Where are those questions? Yeah. Asha Gupta, who's handling it from my office end, gave me the following questions. However, my opening statement on the media would be, is that I have always considered media as a very, very essential part of governance and administration. Otherwise, when you administer, who are you administering for? You are administering for people. And people have a right to know what the government is doing, what the government's policies are, what it is deciding, what it proposes to do, so that the elected representatives can be asked for and sought clarifications. It's also a very important source of information. I cannot imagine a day without newspapers. See how we feel the day when we don't get the newspapers on our table. We feel it's a holiday. It's like a true holiday, because your newspaper reading almost takes the first hour of the day with a cup of tea. And when you don't get newspapers after the Holi or the Diwali, the other day I didn't get my papers, we start to wonder, kya chutti hai? Aaj bilkul hi chutti hai. Because newspapers ke aane se hi lagta hai, din hai kuch, kaam ka din hai. Kyunki it's like a holiday. Aur jo newspaper padh ke maja aata hai, wo online padh ke nahi maja aata. वो आनंद नहीं मिलता है, क्योंकि वो वैरायटी जो मिलती है, क्योंकि आप न्यूज़पेपर जब खोलते हो सब कुछ मिलता है, आप फटाफट पेजेस भी टर्न कर सकते हो. जो ऑनलाइन जाओगे तो एक पेज एट अ टाइम खुलेगा, एक कॉलम खुलेगा, लेकिन जब व्हेन यू ओपन अ न्यूज़पेपर तो कितना मजा आता है. आप सारा एडवर्टाइजमेंट भी देखते हो, आप नई सुनते हो, स्पोर्ट्स पेज भी जाते हो, इकोनॉमिक पेज भी जाते हो, क्राइम पेज भी जाते हो, पॉलिटिकल न्यूज भी जाते हो, कितना कुछ आपको एट वन स्ट्रोक मिल जाता है न्यूज़पेपर से. तो ये बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंट डे है, क्योंकि न्यूज़पेपर्स कितने इंटेग्रल पार्ट हमारी लाइफ का बन चुके हैं. इसके बिना लगता है कि दिन ही नहीं चढ़ा, या दिन में कुछ खराब गया रहा. सवाल ये उठता है कि किस तरीके की न्यूज, किस तरीके के एडिटोरियल्स, किस तरीके के सेंटर पीसेस, किस तरीके के मैसेजेस. जैसे कि आई एम अ वेरी फॉन्ड रीडर ऑफ द स्पिरिचुअल पेजेस, जहां पर भी आता है, चाहे वो हिंदू में आता है, चाहे इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स में आता है, चाहे हिंदुस्तान टाइम्स में आता है, या टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया में स्पीकिंग ट्री आता है, मैं जाके ढूंढती हूँ कि आज की आज का स्पिरिचुअल सेक्शन में क्या क्या आया है, और तकरीबन रोज मुझे उसमें से खुराक मिलती है। सो न्यूज़पेपर सिर्फ आज हमारा हिंदुस्तान का सिर्फ न्यूज ही नहीं दे रहा है, आपको इंस्पिरेशन भी देता है, एडिटोरियल्स भी देता है, एनालिसिस भी देता है, हर सब्जेक्ट पे अलग अलग आर्टिकल्स आते हैं। तो अगर आप एक अखबार से ज्यादा, एक न्यूज़पेपर से ज्यादा पढ़ते हो तो आपको अपनी जरूरत मिल जाती है। अगर आप लॉ एंड ऑर्डर ओरिएंटेड हो तो आपको लॉ एंड ऑर्डर मिल जाएगा, अगर स्पोर्ट्स है तो स्पोर्ट्स का मिल जाएगा, अगर आप इंडस्ट्री और इकोनॉमी के हैं तो आपको इकोनॉमिक्स भी मिल जाएगा, और अगर आप एजुकेशन या पॉलिसीज में है तो आपको वो भी मिल जाएगा। सो आई एम नॉट सेइंग कि इस वक्त मीडिया किधर जा रहा है, आई एम मोर ऑन व्हाट एम आई गेटिंग आउट ऑफ इट एवरी डे। ऑफकोर्स जो हमारा टेलीविजन का मीडिया और डिस्कशन की डिबेट्स हुई है उसमें बहुत ज्यादा स्कोप है, उसमें कंपोजर लाने का, उसमें स्टेबिलिटी लाने का, उसमें गुड मैनर्स लाने का, एक दूसरे को सुनने की बर्दाश्त लाने का। सो देर इज अ स्कोप व्हेन इट कम्स टू टेलीविजन मीडिया और द सोशल मीडिया की मैं इस वक्त बात नहीं कर रही, आई एम ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट एट द मोमेंट द प्रिंट एंड द टेलीविजन। रेडियो इज जस्ट अमेजिंगली म्यूजिकल फॉर अस, तो मॉर्निंग न्यूज उसके बिना मेरा भी गुजारा नहीं, सुबह के 8 बजे की न्यूज एंड 8:30 न्यूज इज जस्ट अमेजिंग। सो द काइंड ऑफ रोल मीडिया प्लेज इन इनफॉर्मिंग अस, इट ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स ऑन विच चैनल यू वॉन्ट टू गो। सर्टनली 8 o'clock मॉर्निंग न्यूज इज एब्सोल्यूटली शुड बी मेड मैंडेटरी के सुनो, क्योंकि उसमें आपको गवर्नमेंट की, कैबिनेट की डिसीजन सारी मिल जाती है। अगर आप 8 से लेकर 8:30 तक मॉर्निंग न्यूज ऑल इंडिया रेडियो के सुन लो तो यू आर रेडी फॉर द डे। सिमिलरली 8:30 to 9 is English, and it is even 7:30 to 8 has regional news. So if you're a tracker of news and if you're a news hungry, then I use the radio to the maximum, particularly the All India Radio, and of course I use the television for the headlines and the debates. But some debates are becoming very stressful in the media, where we should be able to take away the stress. But it bring in more of intellectual discussion where everybody has the capacity to listen to each other's contrary views. There's no harm listening to each other's, but leave it to the viewer to decide what others are saying. So media is also vigilance pillar, jo information vigilance budget. Like for instance, मेरा जो टेलीविजन, मेरा जो न्यूज़पेपर्स और पांडिचेरी के न्यूज़पेपर्स हैं, बिलीव मी ये विजिलेंस है, क्योंकि वी गेट टू नो विद द पिक्चर व्हाट्स गोइंग रॉन्ग वेयर। इनफैक्ट दे आर द आईज एंड इयर्स ऑफ इवन राजनिवास। आई यूज एवरी न्यूज़पेपर क्लिपिंग ऑफ द पेपर्स रिपोर्टेड एंड वर्नैकुलर इन पर्टिकुलर, बिकॉज वर्नैकुलर इज सर्विंग द वर्नैकुलर पीपल। सो कहीं सड़क खराब है, या पॉट होल है, या उसमें मर्डर, उसमें क्राइम की सिचुएशन है, या उसमें कोई डीसिल्टिंग कैनाल ओवरफ्लो कर रहा है, कोई भी ऐसी न्यूज, वो गुड न्यूज तो नहीं देते। गुड न्यूज मेक नो न्यूज इन द न्यूज़पेपर्स। आई हैव नॉट सीन मच ऑफ गुड न्यूज कमिंग अप, दे डोंट मेक न्यूज, बट रॉन्ग थिंग्स हैपनिंग और इनएडिक्वेसी दे मेक न्यूज, विच इज यूर वेरी यूजफुल टू मी एज एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर, बिकॉज देन आई पिक अप द न्यूज़पेपर क्लिपिंग, I get back to the secretary and the department concerned and find out, and things are getting corrected. Thanks to the newspaper reports, we get to know. And also it keeps alert. We use even these newspaper clippings on WhatsApp groups. Straight away, they go to all officers to find out PWD mein koi kami hui, ya education mein kahin kami hui, ya kisi building mein hui, ya kisi policing angle se hui. It's so useful. So media, I'm so happy that we are celebrating the press day. I'm not on what it can do better. At the moment is what it gives us as a daily food, which we are very, very grateful. So I'm happy that you're celebrating the press day. I'm very grateful that the press council was born on this day, and in which Mr. Prem Bhatia played a very integral role in the press council. Of course, the press council, what all does press council do doesn't make much news often. If it does, it will be helpful. Like, for instance, we've recently read about how course corrections have been made on the content on social content media or digital media or video television media. It's very good. But I would love to see more composed debates jahan aapka blood pressure nahi badhe, where you can read and listen carefully and with composure, but absorb everybody's viewpoint with great dignity, and then you'll be able to form a view. That would be a wonderful thing to happen if it happens. But for me, as a police officer, as an administrator, and even as an erstwhile sportswoman, media, the sports page, the crime page. For me, when I joined the Indian Police Service, believe me, in 1972, for me, it was a shift from the sports page to the crime page, because I was so much part of the media to read all my sports news, etc. So I'm a very, very strong lover of reading newspapers. And I also am a documenter. When there's a good article in a newspaper, whether it's on education, whether it's on all subjects which concern me, because I'm a student of liberal arts. So for me, social sciences is very interesting. So I have a whole library of newspaper clippings which go back to 30 years. In fact, I have the news clippings of my sports page from 1966, when I won the National Tennis Championship. I have the news clipping. In fact, ortho certificate mein bhai nahi ki maine national jeeti thi. Mere paas certification aur news jo aaya tha wo hi hai. इसीलिए इसी तरीके से एशियन टेनिस चैंपियनशिप जो मैंने जीती थी 1972 में, तो भी इट इज द न्यूज क्लिपिंग व्हिच इज अ एविडेंस ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट आई डिड विन दिस चैंपियनशिप. अदरवाइज आई हैव नो अदर सर्टिफिकेशन फ्रॉम द ऑल इंडिया लॉन टेनिस एसोसिएशन दैट आई वॉन दिस. सो न्यूज पेपर्स हैव देयर ओन एविडेंशरी वैल्यू, एंड आई थिंक इट्स द वे यू लुक एट द न्यूज पेपर्स. सो फॉर मी, आई हैव ग्रेट रिस्पेक्ट, आई वैल्यू माई न्यूज पेपर्स. I read more. I read about 4 papers every day. I take out my clippings. I save them as a library. I get my morning inspiration from them. I also stay alert. I also read editorial. So all of us, last thing before I switch off, move to your question answers, is I remember when I was a student, my father used to give me a centerpiece of a particular newspaper. And mujhe kehte the, isko padh. उसकी हिंदी इसकी ट्रांसलेशन कर. सो कैन यू बिलीव इट, आई हैड टू रीड द इंग्लिश एंड डू हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन, विच गेव मी द मास्टरी ऑफ वोकैबुलरी, विच गेव द मास्टरी ऑफ माय लैंग्वेज. आई रिमेंबर आई यूज्ड टू ट्रांसलेट मेनी आर्टिकल्स ऑफ डॉम मोरेस. डॉम मोरेस वॉज अ वेरी गुड राइटर. ही यूज्ड टू राइट इन द इंडियन एक्सप्रेस एंड आई यूज्ड टू ट्रांसलेट हिम. मैंने जो आर्टिकल्स पढ़े और ट्रांसलेट किए अभी भी नहीं भूले, क्योंकि वो इंटरनलाइज हो जाते हैं, क्योंकि आप हिंदी वर्ड्स भी सीख लेते हैं. सो जब आप बोल रहे हैं, आपको याद है वो उसका असली मीनिंग क्या, इंग्लिश का, हिंदी का. इट हेल्प मी ह्यूजली इन इम्प्रूविंग माय लैंग्वेज, माय राइटिंग स्किल्स, माय स्पीकिंग स्किल्स, माय नॉलेज स्किल्स. सो आई थिंक एज स्कूल्स ऑफ जर्नलिज्म, सिंस यू आर इन्वाइटिंग स्कूल्स, आस्क देम टू ट्रांसलेट, आस्क, एनकरेज, एंड देन रीराइट द आर्टिकल. ट्रांसलेट, रीड, ट्रांसलेट एंड रीराइट. Rewrite the piece, not by copying, but internalizing. I wish I would have more time only for this luxury of reading, translating, and then transcribing it all, keeping the paper away, which means a very, very good internal knowledge. And last, another thing before I say is I think we need to make our journalists, junior internists, as internship more aggressive, more intense. Because of the urgent needs, they immediately are put on the strings and they're asked to. And I've seen, in fact, the mistakes are coming from more or the urgency to make a story and to sensationalize it, I think, or go wrong with the facts and to do no fact checking is of some people who meant entering it quickly, posting it without being grounded in journalism. It's very, very important that we ground, don't give them a case, a reporting from the city. They must be very stable, need to be stabilized in writing. Because when you write, it hurts. Sometimes it may hurt very wrongly, but it is also right. That's when you become eligible for awards. But we must also be very careful that when you are making allegations or giving insinuations, by the time उसकी life बदल जाती है उस व्यक्ति की, अगर allegations गलत हो. So it's better not to err there. It's very, very important that you respect people's reputations. However, फैक्चुअली अगर आपके हाथ में एविडेंस है तो फिर आप लिखें जरूर कि मेरे पास बेस्ड ऑन एविडेंस है, और अगर आपके पास सुनी सुनाई है, alleged है, आई थिंक इट्स नॉट फेयर. सो वी हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. सो इन स्कूल्स ऑफ जर्नलिज्म वी मस्ट रिस्पेक्ट कि अपने आप को डालो इसमें, पुट योर सेल्फ इन दिस पर्सन पोजिशन, और तुम अब रिपोर्टिंग करो तो तुम कैसे करोगे रिपोर्टिंग. सो स्विचिंग रोल्स इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वेर इट हर्ट्स, वेन यू गेट हर्ट यू रियली रियलाइज वेर इट पिंस, वेर इट पेन्स, वेर इट हर्ट्स. सो ट्रांसलेटिंग and then playing the role modeling, putting training a little more intensive, fact-checking, evidence-based, and of course, being very, very brave and courageous. Because reporting of such, particularly when you are reporting on powerful vested interests, it's not ordinary to go through, but you've had the courage, and then your board may not even permit. So it's this is journalism is also and a profession which demands huge amount of courage. So remembering Mr. Prem Bhatia, a man of principles, a man of great courage, and a man of great versatility, thank you for inviting me on his third Prem Bhatia lecture. Thank you very much, the college, you've invited me. I've tweeted you today, also SD College, for inviting me, and all of you, the School of Department of Journalism, that you done me an honor by being part of it. Thank you. Priya, you have to switch on your mic. Yeah.
Sorry, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. With your permission, ma'am, on behalf of our students, I would like to ask a few questions. First question is by Amisha Obroy. She's a student of BA third year journalism. What is the one thing that inspired you to become something that no other woman ever did?
A lot comes from your upbringing. My upbringing was also very unique. My parents were totally ahead of their time. They were visionaries. They had a vision for us. We were four girls, no boy in the 50s. And remember how boy was important in those days. So I think what inspired me was, compared to many, many other women, I was growing up in such an environment of inspiration. There was ethics in the house. There was peace in the house. There was honesty in the house. There was education in the house. There was sports in the house. There was competition in the house. There was great demand of sharing in the house. So I think that is all coming as inspiration to be what I want to be, because I had everything coming. And when I saw, compared to other girls, I found I was different. My home was different. My parents were different. My school was outstanding. Of course, school was the best in the city of Amritsar, called the Sacred Heart School of Amritsar. My college was also the best in Amritsar, called the Government College for Women Amritsar. That's where I used to come and play in Chandigarh. Hamesha aake tennis matches khelti thi, inter-college khelni aati. So I was in very, very good environment. I had some very, very bright teachers also. So I think to become something like no other woman did was, one thing was that I will not be the ordinary way. I used to see the ordinary women. What I don't mean to say ordinary in the sense, I don't wish to out-downgrade. I don't want to be like others. I want to be different. And number two, I want to grow up to be self-reliant. So that was my inspiration. Ki maine bade hoke apne maa baap ka naam, unko naam ko aana hai. I have to grow up to give, because the expectations of my parents was different. Their inspiration was different. I wanted to live up to the expectations of my parents, number one, to be honest. And gradually I developed a sense of my own identity. So having developed my own sense of identity, inspired by my parents, I wanted to be what I am today. I am exactly the way I wanted to be, self-reliant. Kabhi kisi ke aage haath nahi pilana, kisi ke aage kuch mangna nahi, kuch puchna nahi, dena hai, lena kuch nahi. So it was very inspirational. I think that was the beginning. Your mic. Priya, your mic.
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Sorry. I'm extremely sorry, ma'am. My apologies. Don't worry. Ma'am, the next question is by Gunjan Handa. Did you ever feel like you didn't belong in the world that men dominated in the services?
Well, I loved it. Because I sometimes was the only girl amongst so many boys playing tennis. Only girl traveling amongst all the boys playing tennis. I was the only girl booking reservation seats for them playing tennis. In fact, jo ladke nahi kar sakte the, main karti thi. So wo keh dete the, jab kuch nahi hota, Kiran ko bula lo. Line bahut lambi hai, Kiran ko bula lo. Ye seat nahi mil rahi, Kiran ko bula lo. Ye reservation nahi mil rahi, Kiran ko bula lo. Ye hame paise nahi mil rahe, association se, Kiran ko bula lo. मैं तो उनके लिए काम करती थी. सो फॉर मी इट वॉज लाइक आई वॉज बींग अहेड ऑफ देम ऑलरेडी इन दोज डेज. सो मेरे लिए इट वॉज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वर्ल्ड वेयर आई कुड बी ऑफ हेल्प टू द बॉयज.
थैंक यू मैम. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बाय द्रिति लुंगा. डिड यू फील लाइक वर्किंग एनवायरमेंट working environment was better with United Nations than you got in the police services in India?
Well, the manner in which I served in the police, I think I thoroughly loved it. If I compare it with my United Nations timings, I think I will still choose where I was. The reason was that United Nations was very, very officious, very office, very files oriented. Very structured, very mechanical, many times very mechanical, which I didn't like that kind of suffocating structure. I liked flexibility. It was very rigid because, you see, UN is UN. It has its own standard operating procedures, wherein my policing, sometimes we never had any standard operating procedures. You could be flexible. You could interpret the rule. You can add another procedure. Whereas in the United Nations, it was very structured. This is the standard operating procedure. This is the mandate. You go accordingly, which is not my nature. My nature was innovative. My nature was entrepreneurial. And I felt contained. But if ask me, I think I still would go here because there's no cap on being entrepreneurial and innovative in our services. Nothing. Yeah, yes and no, Neetha. So I think I looked at this, if you ask me today, it's a very unique question you're asking me. Nobody asked me earlier on the compared to United Nations. But I think I liked the kind of flexibility of decision-making sometimes at my level, because everything doesn't go up. Everything doesn't go up to the senior. In the middle level, you can do so many things on your own, which you could not have done at the United Nations. Everything would have gone up for approval because it's diplomatic world. You see, United Nations is a very structured, very careful diplomatic world in niceties and niceties and manners. If everything matters, the rules, the procedures, whereas here, you are at home. आप अपने घर में जो सुधार करना कर लो, कोई मना नहीं करता. लेकिन यूनाइटेड नेशन में सुधार करना है तो पहले देखो रूल में है, लिखा हुआ है, कर सकते हो तो उसका प्रोसीजर है, वो करो. तो प्रोसीजर में ही टाइम चला जाता था. इतने इतने ब्यूटीफुल डॉक्यूमेंट बहुत अच्छे बनते थे, लेकिन डॉक्यूमेंट में ही टाइम चला जाता था. यहां बिना डॉक्यूमेंट काम हो जाता है. हमारे इंडियन सिस्टम में कई बार बिना डॉक्यूमेंट भी कितना कुछ करते हैं, लेकिन गलती भी तो करते हैं ना डॉक्यूमेंट. इसीलिए यूएन में आप गलती भी नहीं कर सकते थे बिकॉज इट वॉज वेरी स्ट्रक्चर्ड. इधर गलतियां भी कर सकते हो तो पता ही नहीं चलेगा. इसी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी का और रिजिडिटी का और स्ट्रक्चरिंग होने का अपने फायदे भी हैं और नुकसान भी हैं. तो जो नुकसान जो फायदे गलत फायदे उठाना चाहते हैं वो गलत फायदे भी उठाते हैं, और जो सही जो एंटरप्रेन्योरल है, इनोवेटिव है, क्रिएटिव है, डायनामिक है, प्रोएक्टिव है, सुधारक है, उनके लिए फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी बहुत काम आती है. मेरे लिए बहुत काम.
थैंक यू मैम. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज बाय यशवी. व्हाट मोटिवेटेड यू टू वर्क एज हार्ड एज यू डिड?
बिकॉज आई वॉज ऑल्सो सीइंग व्हाइल आई न्यू माय फैमिली वॉज गिविंग मी वेरी ग्रेट अपब्रिंगिंग, आई ऑल्सो सॉ द कंडीशन ऑफ वुमेन आउटसाइड. I didn't want that. I wanted a career. I wanted to be self-reliant. I wanted to be self-sufficient. I wanted to be a woman with a total sense of journey and a purpose, and a woman who'd create a name for her parents as well, and a name for myself. I have my own identity. That is what made me work hard, because I had a goal and I had a journey to fulfill. And the journey to my goal was hard work. But I loved hard work. It was not punishing, because I knew it's taking me nearer my goal. Every tennis tournament I played and worked hard, it took me nearer to the championships. Every hard work I did in my class took me to higher grades. Every hard work NCC parade I did took me to the leadership skills. So I had a purpose, is to constantly learn and improve on my own skills and to reach that goal. And every day it became a habit. So hard work became a habit because I had a goal. It was not a donkey's hard work. It was an intelligent hard work. It was planned hard work. It was a goal-oriented hard work. Accomplishing hard work. And also modifying hard work to the sense that I achieve what I want to achieve. That's why time management became very important for me. How do I do the maximum with the minimum time? And so many things. Like being a student, topping in academics for Punjab University Chandigarh in political science in my master's, and also playing tennis outside the university for 5 months in a year and still making it top in the academics and making it number one in India, even in tennis. How? It was all very, very structured as far as my timing was concerned. So it was hard work, but with sense of proportion and planning.
Thank you, ma'am. The next question is from Amajo. I read once that you said, if I look at my journey, I would say that I have not wasted
a day
throughout this journey.
Which is a fact. It's a fact. I spend the day as I want. So it's not wasted. It's invested. But invested in what? Sometimes it's just a walk. Sometimes it's fitness. Sometimes it's reading. Sometimes it's relaxing. It's invested the way I want. I spend the day as I want. Not somebody else decides for me. I decide for myself how I'm going to spend my day. So it's not saying itne baje ye itne baje. Sometimes jab when I was a student, yes, ye chapter itne baje tak khatam hona hai. Ab maine itne baje tak karna hai. Ab mere paas meetings ke schedules hai. I have that structure, but it's my choice. I choose it.
Thank you, ma'am. The next question is by Genesis. You campaign on wide range of issues. If you had to pick one as the main problem India is facing today, what it would be?
I think it would be women empowerment. It would be the issue of half of our population on women empowerment. And when I say women empowerment, it means every woman, just as a man has it in his head, that I have to fend for myself. I have to survive for myself. I have to be a provider. I think so should every woman feel I should be a provider. That means automatically she'll manage her affairs in such a way that she provides for herself. She provides for her family. She provides for everybody. But she's a provider and not a dependent one day. I would say I want an education message to every girl that, look, you are being equally educated like a boy is also being. So tere dimag mein kyun nahi hai ki main bhi bade hoke apni family ko provide karungi? Why should the parents look for a son to provide? Why can't the parents think the girl, daughter can also provide? Wo to hi kar sakegi if she's also providing for herself. But that doesn't mean that she doesn't become a mother. It's her choice. That means she will become a mother only those many times when she wants to become a mother and number of times of a mother, and not somebody else decides for her. That also means that she will be looking for equal partnerships in her work. She will say, look, tum bhi kaam karoge, main bhi kaam karungi. तुम भी घर आओगे मैं भी घर आऊंगी तुम भी खाना खाओगे मैं भी खाऊंगी तुम भी तुमको मैं खिलाऊंगी तुम मुझे भी खिलाओगे So it becomes a home of not designed roles, structured roles, but a one of togetherness. I would love to invest into women, to see every woman grows up to say, bete, jahan tumhe jo bhi opportunity, that is leading to skill development. That means every child, when they grow up, boy or a girl, learns a skill and then becomes dependent, not only waiting for a job, but also entrepreneurship. If you go to Gujarat, a state like Gujarat, it doesn't wait for jobs. Women are very strong entrepreneurs. They create a business like this. They're very business oriented. They create entrepreneurship. Gujaratis are by nature very entrepreneurial. Why not? Why don't we make that skills development in school education will make our girls entrepreneurial. So if I were to do it, I will make sure every girl child learns a skill of her choice and of her preference while in school. She must have a fallback skill, and then she can develop her own need, her purpose, and her career the way she wants. Automatically, you will see Indian population will come down to quality and not numbers. Healthier and not needing all the time dependence on nutrition. She herself will be healthier and not be dependent on the government for every little thing. We will have a developed country only when a half of our population amongst women are empowered to become, believe that I have to grow up like the boys to be self-reliant. I'm a daughter of my parents. When my parents are higher in age, if ever they need me, I am there as much as their son is. The day the Indian woman starts thinking like this, that I am there for my parents as much as my brother is, then the parents' choice is who do they want to work with. So I think that kind of companion relationship, even in marriage, only then will your multiplication of children will go down and population will get contained. Otherwise, till 2040, 45, our population will continue to grow till it stabilizes by 45. Where will more roads come? So I'm not saying empower women to contain population. I'm saying empower women because this is their need. This is their need. Other things will all follow, fall in place.
Thank you, ma'am. One last question. Can you tell us your vision behind starting Navjyoti Foundation and India Vision Foundation by Karan Paluja?
Both have a story behind it. Navjyoti was born as a solution to crime prevention. Navjyoti is today more than 32 years old. It grew up with me. When I was walking the streets and working on crime prevention, for me, that is a priority. Crime prevention to me is priority along with crime detection as a police officer. And I found in the slums, many children out of school, many children into drugs, many women into drug abuse, drug selling. I started the Navjyoti Foundation to start to treat drug abuse. Open schools for these children, because if I would send these children to, because these children used to be part of the burglaries, they would jump over the little gate, open the kunda, unlock it, and then the main burglar would come and they would assist the burglar in opening the doors and they would get a fee for that. So they became inducted into small crimes of burglary, and then they would also sell small drugs because they were not in school. So I want to work on crime prevention. So I opened drug abuse treatment centers as police officer in a police station premises. 8 police station barracks had 8 centers running in 1986 and 87. Nowhere in the world ever did police station have a drug abuse treatment center. We opened it in 1988, 89, and Navjyoti was born then. We called the programs Navjyoti. And I was now getting transferred. So the people said, madam, aap to transfer hoke ja rahe, ye itne kaam ka kya hoga? To maine kaha, phir main kya karu? Main ruk to sakti thi ek jagah. To bole, madam, aap sanstha banao. And that is how Navjyoti Society was born, and today it is reaching out to thousands and thousands of people in the areas of many. That for you to see the website on. So it grew, and I continued to serve. So while I was in service, I continued to strengthen it. It was founded by a set of 11 police officers headed by the then police commissioner, Mr. Ved Marwa. So he allowed me to register it as a society. I became the thinking general secretary, and all other police serving police officers became members. And till now, that organization is there, going very strong. It has done wonders in its own area. Second was India Vision Foundation. In 1994, when I got the Magsaysay Award from Philippines, it came with $20,000. It had a lot of good money. It also had a vision. And I was in police prisons as IG prison at that time. And I was educating children of prisoners who were not getting any schooling. So I opened schools for them inside the prison. So now I was time to leave. 95, and now I got an award. Awards have a reason. You also have Prem Bhatia Award, I know. So awards always have a reason. Awards aate hain, aapko empower karne ke liye aur kuch dene ke liye. So that was the vision. When I went to receive the award, I said, this award is now dedicated to a foundation called India Vision Foundation, which will educate the prisoners' children when they are inside the prison and outside the prison. And to today, now it's more than 25 years old. We've been educating and prisoners' children, but we've gone beyond that to do prison programs inside the prison. So this is how both of them came by destiny. One only to prevent crime, but it grew. And I had a very good police commissioner, Ved Marwa, who allowed me to do this, who allowed me to register. This is the first time in India where a serving police officer's department registered a society of this kind. So that's why I'm continuing to mention him. And secondly is India Vision, which came through the Magsaysay Award, where I myself saw a need for it, and it's still a need. In fact, this program is very uniquely being done by India Vision Foundation. You don't have a parallel of this kind easily in the rest of India and even in the world, what we are doing under India Vision Foundation. So they were solutions providing. It was solutions providing.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for such an inspirational session. We are extremely honored and blessed. Your words of wisdom will continue to show us the way ahead to new glories. Now, I would like to request Dr. Anirudh Joshi, General Secretary, DBSC College Society, to give the vote of thanks.
Whoever is to do it has to switch on the mic also and their video also. Priya, whoever you are giving to either probably doesn't have the mic on or even the video on. I see that.
I would like to request Dr. S.C. Vaidya, to General Secretary of GGDSC College Society, to give the vote of thanks.
They're not getting the mic on, and they're not getting the video on also. Yeah. He is connecting, but not getting the mic. Unmuting. Yeah, hello. Now it's unmuted.
Hello.
Go ahead. Yeah. Please carry on.
Good evening to all of you. Madam, what a treat it was. Thank you very much. It's once in a while we get this type of treat. And we know it's your love for education. Is your love for Chandigarh city, and is your love for GGST college that you very gladly agreed to be sharing with us your thoughts and your thought process. All of us are very enlightened, and you have given so much food for our thought that we will all benefit out of it. Yes. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. With this, we would like to conclude. Thank you, Jai Hind.
Thank you, Jai Hind. Thank you, Priya. Thank you.
Thank you so much, distinguished members of the Management Society, my colleagues and dear students.